Hi everybody, thanks for coming back to 1MinuteDigital.com. Today I'm going to talk about color separating your files in Photoshop to get them ready for a printer, for an offset printer. This does not apply to digital printing or four-color offset printing, where it's okay to have four-color channels. But when you have, say, stationery business cards, envelopes that are two-color for your client's brand, specific colors, when you send a four-color digital file to a local printer, they're going to kick it back to you and tell you it is not color separated. So this is how you do that. Now, here's your logo. I've made this out of just sort of generic shapes from Photoshop, but it is a two-color logo. It's orange and black, and now you've worked on this. You've gone back and forth with your client. They love it. You love it. Everyone's happy. Now you're ready to print their letterhead. If you get this ready like this and send it to a printer, they're going to kick it right back to you, and they would be right, because even though it looks like two colors, if we go to Window, Channels, we can see here in our Channels palette that is actually four colors. There is a black channel, there is a yellow channel, there's a magenta channel, and a cyan or blue channel. This is four channels for your printer. They're going to have to make four different plates for this two-color logo, and they're not going to want to do that. It's only going to be two colors. So what we do in this case is start making it a two-color logo. So let's start with our rectangle in the background here. Double-click on it, and there are many ways to do this, but this is the quickest and easiest way, and it's just going to show you how this process works. Let's go to Color Overlay, and it was probably about here somewhere, like a black, which is a mixture of all these four colors, the cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. What we want to do is make it 100% black. So on the C channel there, make it 0, M channel 0, yellow channel 0, and black channel, or the K, is 100%. Now that rectangle is 100% black. It is not a mixture of CMYK, and say okay. Now our little hairs here I think already have a color overlay of white, but let's check that. Color overlay. Yes, it is 0000. That means it is white. There's no color there whatsoever. Okay. Now our 1 minute haircuts here. We're not going to do a color overlay for that because we want it two colors on this line. So let's just select the word haircuts here. Go over to our color picker and change it again to 0 cyan, 0 magenta, 0 yellow, and 100% black. Say OK. Now the word haircuts is only black. Let's do the same for the word 1. Use your color picker, and it already defaulted, but make sure it is 0, 0, 0, and 100% K, or black. Say OK. Now this word minute. Highlight that. Again, go to your color picker. Now we're not going to make it orange. We're going to make it 100% magenta, because when printers make plates, they only make one of four colors, the C, M, Y, or K. It doesn't matter which color you make it, but it has to be 100% of one of these. So let's make it magenta. Let's say 0 cyan, 100% magenta, 0 yellow, and 0 black. And say OK. And now that is 100% magenta. Let's do the same thing for our scissors, which we want to match that color. Color overlay, and it's already defaulted to that, but just to be sure, we want to make sure it's 0 cyan, 100% magenta, 0 yellow, and 0 K, and say OK. And now, if we look at our channels, we can see now that it is only two channels. There's only artwork on two of these channels, the black, and when we hide that, all that disappears because that's 100% black, and the magenta. When we highlight that, everything that's magenta disappears, the scissors and the word minute. There's nothing on the cyan channel and nothing on the yellow channel. There's only two color channels there, and then they can make the plates. They're going to make it 100% magenta and 100% black, and that is perfect for what they want. What you will do, most printers will have a selection of colors, basic colors that you can print with no extra charge, which is your basic red, orange, blues, greens, etc. And so you would tell them, print the black channel black and the magenta channel orange, or whatever Pantone color you might specify. If your client has a specific Pantone color that they want their orange to be, in this case, it would be that, you know, PMS, blah, 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 whatever that is. If you don't know what Pantone colors are, just Google that and you'll find out a lot about Pantone color swatches. But basically, this is a print-ready logo that is ready to go to your printer, and you tell them which colors are which, and they're happy to print that for you. Okay, I hope this was helpful, and of course, more tutorials to come. You can tweet me, everybody, at 1MinDigital on Twitter. and I would be happy to answer any questions, or if you just want to share some of your artwork with the digital community, that is always fun. So until next time, bye-bye.